Sorry, I got interrupted, but I guess that was my husband. He's on his way to work, so I'm headed home. He was just warning me that when I pull into our subdivision that the kids are out and about in the streets and their parents are not watching them, so he wants me to be careful. He said he wasn't gonna call me because I don't like lectures, but God told him that he needed to let me know what was ahead of me. So I do appreciate that. And I thank God that we can be obedient to his voice and do what he says, because just imagine if we didn't, it could cost us. And then the first thing we would say is, oh wow, God, man, why me? But we can't always say that, because then you sit down and have time to think and you realize that voice that you heard, that intuition that you had, that conscious mind, that was the Holy Spirit telling you. And what is the Holy Spirit? It's God. So Jesus didn't go away and leave us the Holy Spirit for nothing. So, you know, we got to take heed to that. But as I was saying before my husband interrupted, I just really let, things were getting to me today. And I really felt that people that are of God, that they should be considerate also of how they take tone with people or how they address things on the floor, excuse me, that we should just be considerate of one another, because tables could turn one day and you wouldn't want anyone to do those things to you. And this is just how I'm feeling, you know. And as my husband may say, I'm acting like a baby, but no, we're all accountable. So that means that if you consider yourself a child of God, and we're all accountable. And yes, you have to bring things to people's attention, you know, their situations, you know. And yes, we have to do our job, but there is a way to do them. You know, you just don't talk. Would Jesus talk to you like that? No. Would he clown you on the floor in front of people because he was having a bad day? If Jesus was upset because the disciples were betraying him or going about doing stuff and he wanted them to pray, or even, here's a good example. Remember when Jesus told them that he was going to be praying and that he put them on watch? And when Jesus came from praying, what were they doing? They were sleeping. I mean, Jesus could have led into them and just went off, but he still remained humble, because there's a way to get your point across, and there's a way you can talk to people. And that goes for how you talk to people in email, in person. It's just, hey, call me sensitive. I don't think I'm being sensitive. I just think that as I've grown according to God, I've learned to guard my tone, guard the things I say, and think before I speak of how I'm saying things to people, or if I am still heated about a situation or what have you, I remain quiet so that I can go and get Elease together and then, you know, confront the issue or whatever. Because when you do things right, when you are teed off, pissed off, or what have you, then you forget about people's feelings and you just want to get your point across. And some people don't think about it until later and think, wow, I should have said this a different kind of way. And then some people just don't give a hmm, you know? So I'm just kind of just, I won't say I'm irritated anymore. I'm just kind of like, upset, but I'll get over it. I mean, this too shall pass. You know, I just want to say once again, I thank God for his word. I thank God that I can just OD on it so that I can, you know, overcome that situation. And I thank God that I'm a better woman of God now, because the old me wouldn't say good night, wouldn't call, wouldn't do this. I would just let you be mad and whatever and let you think what you think. But because I'm trying to help build God's kingdom and be a good steward and a good example, you know, sometimes we have to take humiliation. Sometimes we have to be insulted or our feelings get hurt and we can't address it right then and there because maybe we haven't grown in that area, or maybe at that particular time we don't know what to say and the words could roll out and you could say some things that possibly could get you in trouble, possibly